Hey guys, and welcome back to a brand new Battle Buddies Q&A. So, normally I always ask the questions on my YouTube community tab, but this time I decided to do it a little differently and ask the questions in my Discord, link below by the way. So, without further ado, let's go over all the epic questions that I got asked for this Battle Buddy Q&A. Let's go. Blue Bolt Bomber asked, there has been talk about removing the ability to get a tester badge. Originally, you stated that you would remove it after the Christmas event. So, when is it gonna be removed? So, this is a great question. So, the badge, like the tester badge and the tester skin, will become unobtainable after the next update. So originally the update was supposed to be after the Christmas event, but because of school, because of all the holidays, we didn't make that. Now we're also like a month, like way past the due date. But unfortunately, we couldn't make that deadline. So the tester skin and the tester badge will be unobtainable in the next update. So if you, for whatever reason, haven't played through the Battle Buddy tutorial yet, this might be your only chance left to get this epic tester skin. The next question is from Asu. When will PvP mode return? Fun fact, I already coded the entire PvP back into the game for the next update. However, it will not appear and be available in the next update. The reason for that is that we have something big planned for PvP. We want to make ranking systems, we want to be able to challenge friends. So that won't be done by next update. However, PvP will be coded into the game and can be accessed by developers. So there probably will be some Battle Buddy streams next update in which we will test out PvP against viewers and see if everything works correctly, see if there are any unexpected glitches because of PvP. And hopefully the update after that, we will see PvP in the game. So I hope it answers your question. So not next update, but hopefully the update after that. TJ Constable asks, will all the super rare buddies be available on every map, or will there be a certain super rare buddy for each individual map? So how we planned the rare buddy system is, for example, we got a rare buddy and let's call it rare buddy Bob. So rare buddy Bob will only be available in the forest. He won't be available in the alley. He won't be available in the future maps. So yes, a super rare buddy is locked to a map. The reason why we did this is because we feel like it gives old maps a lot more replayability. And we just kind of still wanted to keep like the buddies that could spawn somewhat themed to the maps. So yeah, right now super rare buddies are locked to a map. But maybe in the future there will be rare buddies that have a chance to appear in multiple maps. So we are not quite sure about that yet. But for next update, every map will have a super rare buddy. Hopefully. Drip asked, were there ever plans on buddies that were gonna make it in the game, but end up not being in the game? Actually, there's been quite a lot. And a lot of these were buddies suggested in the very first month of developing. When it was still only me, no modeler, no texture, everything was done by me. And there are still some buddies from that that I still really want to add this update. I want to add them probably in the buddy shop. The reason why I didn't yet is that a lot of you guys have let me know that you wanted to see buddies suggested from people that haven't had a buddy in the game yet. And that's what we try to focus on for the buddy shop, to give people that haven't had anything in the game yet a buddy in the game. So that's why we didn't pick those buddies. But those buddies will come eventually to the buddy shop. And that's why I am not revealing them right now. So I bunched these two questions together because they're kind of the same. Mr. Pineapple Tree Plushy asked, will there ever be a human Maya skin? And Professional Morgana adds on to that, will there ever be humanoid buddy skins? So from the very start of the game, I actually already coded a system that allows for skins with a different rig. Like for example, Maya could be a dragon or a human or a horse. That's all possible within the skin code. Right now, Human Maya is very, very popular in the Discord. I would want to add her. Well, of course, we first have to track down who started it, if the person is okay with it being in the game. But human versions for buddies, I would be down for that. They will probably be exotic, so you have a lot to grind, but I would totally be down for that. Cyber Hectic asks, this may be too early, but the buddies are very iconic. So I was wondering, do you have plans to make other games outside of Battle Buddies with the troops of Battle Buddies? I included this question because this is actually super funny, but literally a week ago I talked with my girlfriend about this exact thing, where we talked about how iconic the buddies are becoming. And if I were ever to make side projects with the buddies. And my answer to that was yes. I am very well planning to do that. These side games will probably be very, very small and simple games. Just for the fact that, let's say I get burned out from developing on Battle Buddies for a bit. I just want to have like a quick, you know, a quick game project to work on. To refresh in my mind. So that will probably come somewhere in the future. So we get like an entire, like Battle Buddies will be the main game. And then you have like side games. If that ever were to happen, we probably will give special skins in Battle Buddies if you complete challenges in the side games. So that might be cool. That will be coming eventually. But for now, I am really, really hyped to work on the actual Battle Buddies. So that's what I'll be doing. Lewasome Doggo asks, how do you think of making Battle Buddies go faster? Since you said you will make the game faster. I will make the game faster. It's literally what I told you to do. Walk speed will be faster. Cooldown will be faster. Token gain will be faster. Attack speed will be faster. Everything in the game that relies on timing will be speed up. So if you ever played the mobile game, you know, like the times 2 speed button in the corner. It's basically that, but it's always on. You cannot turn it off. You cannot turn it on. It's just always on. That's basically how you gotta see it. So matches goes 1.25 as fast. And that's quite fast. You will be able to do a lot more matches per hour. So that's very exciting for all you grinders out there. Owen Gamer asks, if the game gets a big following and many players actually play it, let's say about 2k or more, will you still continue to allow people to submit buddy submissions? Yes, my dream for the game is that it's a very community-driven project, meaning everybody can send buddies, everybody can send skins, and I want to give everybody that comes up with a good enough design have a chance to see their creation in the game. That's something that I wanted when I started the game. It's something that I still want now, and probably something that I still want to do in the future, even though the game gets really big. Although, I have to say though, if the game ever does blow up, it does make it harder for people to get their stuff in the game, because there will be so many suggestions, and at that point we really have to pick the best of the best. King of Lemons asked, will new buddies be added to old maps? Yes and no. A no in the fact that we won't be changing the default waves, and there won't be new buddies in the default maps. yes in the fact that every mob will get a couple of rare, ultra rare buddies. So, by that logic, we're kinda adding new buddies to new maps, but I'm not quite sure if that's what you meant. Drip asks, I know Castaway Cove isn't out yet, but do you have any plans for other maps, like design-wise? We have so many map ideas, we already have like 3 or 4 extra maps already completely modeled, like standing out. I'm not quite sure if these maps will actually be stages in the game. We might see these maps in the stage builder or in PvP, but we got some maps like laying around, so don't worry about that. Big Boy asks, will there be any purpose to the buddy shop currency once a player has bought all the buddies from the buddy shop? At this update, unfortunately, not. You will just buy the buddies and then you save up the tokens for when new buddies release. We might plan on adding a conversion where you can convert the buddy shop currency to tickets or something, but at this moment I'm not quite sure about that. We first really have to see how much people grind, how much tokens people actually rack up and collect. So only time can tell for now, but for the next update, you will only be able to buy buddies. Brick asks, do you think there will ever be too many buddies? What number of buddies do you think you'll stop making buddies? Or will there be always new content? Additionally, how do you feel about the number of maps for the future of Battle Buddies? Will there be a point when no more maps will be added due to too many maps? So, if we ever, ever reach the stage where there are too many buddies and too many maps, we will still add map designs for the stage builder, probably. So, about the too many buddies, this is quite a difficult one, but what I dream for Battle Buddies to be is to be like Pokemon, where you have like 150, you know, buddies, but all of them are iconic and none of them are super forgettable. That's the main thing that I want to happen in Battle Buddies. That's just all I care about. Like, I don't think there can be something like too many buddies, but there could be a thing like too many similar buddies. So yes, we will be keep adding buddies, but we will try to make them all very unique. Animatronic Destro asked, do any of the buddies have secret backstories that we don't know about or have not found yet? Yes, and I'm not gonna reveal them. So originally, there was gonna be a very big hint to one of the characters' backstories on the alleyway, but last minute, I actually removed that before uploading the map. So the background stories and the lore will be revealed at some point. The main reason why we haven't revealed it yet is because I'm still really thinking about adding a story mode after like maybe a year or two, like when the game is actually, you know, has a lot of content. And because of that, I don't want to reveal any backstories yet. I'm sorry. Xojo asks, will you end the video in the Q&A? And I most certainly will. In fact, this is the end. I really hope you guys found out a lot about the new update for Battle Buddies, a lot about the stuff I want to do in the future, and I hope all the answers satisfied you. But anyway guys, thank you all so much for watching. If you like this video and want to see more, please hit like and subscribe button. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye!